Welcome back. You're with 10's Morning News. A new tactic is being used to crack down on domestic violence. Every year, tens of thousands of women report assaults, and it's hoped tough new guidelines will stop repeat offences.
It's easy to understand why this man wants to conceal his identity. Verbal abuse ruined his first marriage and almost cost him his second.
And I would get angry and frustrated, and then it more than likely would turn into personal attacks. And it's just not right.
But thanks to new, tougher state government guidelines for domestic violence rehab programs, this 53-year-old has turned his life around.
It's given me the opportunity to really step back and say, you know what, that was wrong. I shouldn't have said that.
According to the state's Attorney General, domestic violence has reached epidemic proportions.
We've had too many tragedies in our community. The people who have lost their lives, people whose lives have been ruined. And it's completely and utterly unacceptable. Stop the violence, because we will stop you.
Domestic violence advocate Betty Green counsels battered women every day. She welcomes strict new guidelines to put a stop to even low-level offending.
Verbal abuse, we should be taking that very seriously, as well as psychological abuse, emotional abuse, controlling finances, not allowing somebody to have access to money or decision making.
And it's behind closed doors of homes in quiet, leafy streets across the country that the cycle of domestic violence continues. It's estimated that one in five Australian families will experience some type of domestic violence. Making matters worse, it's too often passed down from generation to generation.
Happened with my father and his father beforehand, so trying to put a stop to it and say it's not right.
Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.